Okay, I got a little herd dynamics here. Roper was just let out here in his pasture. So Tanner was out, and I just let him back in, so he had to go over and claim his mare. So you can see the Roper wants to stay. Roper's the paint. And Tanner let him stay, which kind of surprises me. See how they're kind of like, hey, remember me? So they've been hanging out for the last few minutes, being buddies. She's in heat. Notice her tail. She's spreading her legs. She'll be squirting here in a second. He's a gelding. He thinks he's a high gelding. So he's kind of claimed her as his mare because they were out here. And it was just him and this other paint. So they're both mares. So because he claimed them, Buddy and Tanner were out there playing around this morning while I was doing some fence mending and stuff. And now they're coming in to get a drink. And you're going to notice in a minute, as soon as Tanner gets his drink, he's like, I'll let you keep her for a minute. But as soon as I get my drink, I'm going to head back over there and show you who's the boss. Got a little mare, little kitty's following me, so the mare wanted to come over here. I got to be careful. When you get in these herd situations, you got to be careful because these horses come over here to see me. Then Tanner come over here to try to take that mare, and I'm in the middle of three horses fighting, and they're all trying to get away, and I'm the smallest guy in there. So you don't want to. That gate open there, that's creating a draw. Roper may try to get out. And see, she's going to go see Tanner because that's kind of her main squeeze there is Big T because they spend a night in the pasture together. So they're over there getting a drink, and she left Roper. And you notice Roper's keeping his distance. He's not walking in on these horses over here saying, hey, you know what? I know my place. Tanner, although he doesn't back down from Tanner a whole bunch. So see, he's already scoping out other mare. That's Lacey in there. That's another mare that he can kind of hang with. So he's when horses get pushed, they kind of got to push, or they look for somebody to push, or they immediately go to something else, which is why they say you always have to replace something, some behavior with another behavior. So when a horse cribs, you can't just go in there and try to beat him every time he cribs or shock him or put up hop wire and do all this crazy stuff. You have to replace that. So you put him out with other horses. Then he ends up looking for mares and grazing and getting pushed. Tanner's wagging his tail, and he's telling her to come on out there. Looks like a big old horse fly around Tanner there. Boy, I wish I could get over there and get that. Darn. It is. Let me see if Big T will let me come out here. If I can get this horse fly. Hang on, Big T. I'll get him, bud. Teach you how to get a horse fly. I've been wanting good boy. Okay, it's going on the mare now. Hi, Big T. I know. Mean old fly. He's like, oh, Big T didn't want to do nothing. See that horse? As soon as Tanner came over me, that horse, here they come. Tail flashy. Tanner's pushing him using the drive line. Roper just kicked and threatened. Tanner went in there. The other horse kicked. Look at Tanner backing up. The other horse yielded. Now, Buddy's right here like, dude, what's going on? He's going to give us face. He's watching and learning. That mare's in heat. See, look at Roper. Roper just challenged Tanner. Now this mare's over here. Tanner's going to come back over here. Because Tanner took this mare, Roper said, okay, I'm going to go get this other mare. So he got that mare. So Tanner came back over here to his mare, and Buddy and this mare. Oh, I don't want to get in the middle of you guys. A little squabble here. So Buddy wants to come with me because I got this camera. He thinks he's going to get fed. Back to that classical conditioning. So I'll go ahead and pet him. So Tanner's got his mare. And now this mare is going to walk over here, and I don't want her. See, she's getting in me in the middle here. That's dangerous. I don't want to get in between these two because Buddy's going to do that, and then she's going to do that. Next thing you know, she kicks out, and I'm laying in the pasture. Somebody's wondering whatever happened to that video that Rick was making. You don't get between horses when they're doing this. You have to really be, I call that horse awareness or horse sense. You know, there's a lot of horse sense out there. Unfortunately, horses are the most... have the most of it, or they're the only ones that have it. So I thought there was going to be a little bit more activity out here, and I wanted to get it in case Tanner and Roper really had a little talking. But this happens when you get horses in and out of pasture. See, Roper was in the other pasture with some other mares, and he was getting too attached, and he wasn't coming in. So now he's moved over here. Well, anytime you start moving around horses like that, you're going to create herd problems. You're going to have squabbles. Now, because he's out here today, when I come back here tonight, Buddy's going to probably have a couple little kick marks or scratches. Tanner might have a couple hoof prints on his butt. Roper's probably going to have a couple hoof prints on his butt. The mares may get in the middle, and they may have a couple bites or hoof prints. Because Tanner's going to... he's going to make her stay with him and say, hey, you need to stay with me. And she'll learn not to leave him and not to go to that other horse. Because he can't fight that horse if she's trying to get to the other horse. And she's trying to get to him, and he's trying to keep him away, so they're both trying to get to each other. That's just a lot of work for one horse to do. So he's not going to be able to do that. Hi, bud. What are you doing? So what he will do is he's going to train his mare and say, hey, you better stay with me. And he's going to impress upon her that I'm the leader. And don't make me come get you, or I'll make you run, or I'll put you in a corner, or I'll separate you from the rest of the herd. He's going to discipline her and tell her what to do so she's not trying to go to that other horse. Now, Roper pretty much submitted, as you can tell, and the other little paint submitted. So she's like, you know, the paint out there is lower than this mare. And again, since she's lower, she already knows her position. So Tanner wants the high horse. Buddy wants all of her. You're a good boy. I know. So Tanner wants the high mare because he's the high horse. And in a minute, he'll go take that mare too and say, I got them both. And Roper will be out there by himself. And then him and Buddy will start hanging around. And then Buddy will go hang out with Tanner, the high horse, because being next to the high horse implies authority or relationship. And since Buddy and Tanner have been together for a long time, Tanner doesn't push Buddy a whole bunch, and Buddy doesn't try and take mares from Tanner. So they have this relationship, so there's no conflict because they stay together all the time. People always want to put their horses up at night. They want to change pastures. I want to put my horse in a turnout. I want to keep him separated from other horses. He's getting too Buddy sour. He's getting this. They want to come up with all these excuses. Every time you change herd dynamics and you put horses up, you have herd dynamics pecking order taking place the next day. And that's the problem with why people say, I can't keep my horse with other horses, because they always fight. They always fight because you don't leave them alone. You don't let them finish working it out. I get more questions. I put my horse out, and those mean horses were just chasing her, and they were being mean to her, and I had to go save her and pull her out. Now I can't put her in pasture because of those mean horses. Look, those horses are being horses. They're going to be mean to what you perceive to be mean. They're not being mean. They're being horses. They're working out pecking order. They're pushing. They're doing the same thing your horse does to you when you're whining and complaining about, my horse don't listen. My horse pulls on the bit. My horse won't tie. My horse doesn't lead good. They're doing the same thing as you they're doing out there. The only problem is you try to keep them in where you think you have control over them, and you don't. So what does a horse learn? He learns to disrespect people. He learns that people can't control me. He learns that he never gets a discipline. When he gets out here with a bunch of horses, they don't play that, give me the pink blanket and I'll love you crap. Okay? Horses don't care about that. Horses care about respect. Tanner will bite that mare and look at them. They're eating together and they're lovey-dovey and they're eating on the same blade of grass and they're smelling and they're bonding and they're rubbing just like Buddy's rubbing on me. And bonding. Horses are going to be nice and gentle, but don't confuse that with them being mean or angry or wanting to bite when they correct each other. Because Tanner will correct her and she will correct Tanner. If Tanner, good boy, if Tanner pushes her, I'm going to beat you. If Tanner pushes her right now too much, she'll turn around, rear her tail, slam, give that merry meow whine, and tell Tanner to knock it off. Tanner will be like, all right, well, whatever, I'll go watch football game or go have a drink or something. And then he'll leave her alone because he knows she's in one of her moods. She says enough's enough. But that doesn't mean she doesn't care about him. She doesn't respect him. She doesn't want to be with him. Horses correct each other. And when people figure that out and they don't look at when I correct my horse, I'm being mean, or I don't want to ruin my relationship, or I want my horse to love me, or he was abused. All that makes spoiled bad horses, and it makes horses confused. They don't understand. Because sooner or later, you're going to get pushed or hurt, and then you're going to react, and you are going to correct. And because you haven't done it consistently, because you haven't shown the horse what the limits are, the horse is confused. And he's like, what? Usually this woman lets me get away with everything. And usually she just gives me treats. And normally she just puts those pretty pink hoof boots on me and the pretty pink blanket and just loves on me, and now all of a sudden she corrected me. Well, that's kind of odd. I wonder why she did that. Oh, well, I'll just ignore her because I know I'm bigger and stronger than her and she won't do it again. And even if she does do it, it doesn't hurt that much anyway because I know she'll just, you know, give me a cookie or put me in a stall and feed me. So that's what you're training your horse. That's how you need to get in a horse's mind. When I tell people, think like a horse, understand what a horse is thinking. That's what you need to be doing. How do horses talk to each other in the herd? How do horses push each other? How does Buddy know when I got this camera that he can push me and keep getting all in my space and I don't correct him? Because he's learned it. I've taught him that by letting him get away with it. So anyway, Buddy and Tanner, or Tanner's got his mare. These two little paints out here are happy. I was expecting a lot more. Now you're going to see Buddy walk over here, and you're not going to see Tanner push him because he's no threat. Maybe. See, they walked over, and they're going to say, hey, how you doing, buddies? So they're going to scratch each other. They're renewing their relationship. That's what pisses me off when people want to push horses out of their space. Get away from me. Don't get... These horses know how to walk up gentle. They move their head around each other nice and soft. They know how to nibble and scratch each other. This is bonding. They're not biting. And you know, I don't want my horse putting their lips on me. They'll bite me. You know, if your horse can't do what these horses are doing to you, then you're not, you don't have a relationship with your horse. Both my horses will nuzzle me. They'll put their lips on me. You know, I'm not worried about it because we have an understanding. We talk. I know where horses are coming from. And I don't ambush them or make them fearful of me all the time. I don't push them and say, get out of my space. Respect me. Don't put your lips on me because this one clinician or this one guy trainer told me, don't ever let a horse put his lips on you because he'll bite you. So I've been doing that for my whole life and I wonder why my horse don't like me or don't want to be around me. Well, you know what? You've got to learn to think like a horse if you want a relationship with a horse. Buddy and Tanner, if you watch them, Buddy will be a pain in the butt, and he'll jump on Tanner, and he'll push Tanner, and when Tanner's had enough, he'll turn his butt and say, you better knock it off, and he'll warn him with a halfway kick. And if Buddy keeps pushing, Buddy will get one right dead center of the chest with a rear hoof. He'll have a hoof mark. He'll walk away coughing, dropping his head like, what the hell was that? And you know what? He says, okay, I guess Tanner don't want to play anymore. I'll go play with someone else. It's not personal, and it's not mean. It's just horses being horses. And I really wish people would understand that if you want to be a good horseman and you want to have a relationship with a horse, you have to get in a horse's mind. And I was around horses for years when I was younger, and I didn't know any of this. I didn't believe any of this. This was all horse whisper BS. This was all crap that other people tried to tell me just because they wanted to talk. Well, as I got older and wiser and I figured it out, you know, when you've been around horses for so many years and you figure these things out and people tell you something, you might want to pay attention. Of course, when you're young, you don't want to pay attention to nobody because you got it all figured out as soon as you hit 18 or 20. But as you get older, you start figuring out every 5, 10 years, you learn so much that you thought you knew and you're like, wow. And then when you see somebody, you know, a 20-year-old will see a 10-year-old and go, man, that guy's a kid. He don't know nothing. And a 30-year-old will see a 20-year-old and go, he don't know nothing. And a 40-year-old will see a 30-year-old and go, he don't know nothing. And a 50-year-old will see a 40-year-old and go, he don't know nothing. I got 10 years on him. Well, it's hard to understand that till you start getting up in years. And, you know, I got 60 and 70-year-olds calling me kid. I'm like, dude, I'm 50 years old here. You're calling me a kid. Well, to them, I have a kid because they've been around a lot of years. They know a lot of things and a lot of things that I think I got figured out that they've experienced. They're probably looking at me saying he don't know nothing. And that's what horsemanship is. It's a lifelong journey. And the more horses you have, the more you understand. Look at Buddy's gentle little nuzzle there. He's just rubbing his fur and they're just grooming each other and they're just being buddies. And they're being herd pastors because they're together all the time. And are they going to have squabbles and maybe push and get on each other's nerves? Yeah. And are they going to have a squabble over food sometime? A little bit, not much. But they stay together. It's consistent. They know what's... What are you coming out here whining for? What are you doing? So they, horses know. So they had their little thing and now Tanner's like, okay, I'm going to go reaffirm my relationship with this other horse. And that's what... She just whacked him with her tail. Did you see that? She whacked him, and then she turned her butt. Stinking mares, women, you can't figure them out. Anyway, oh God, I'll be getting hate mail on that one. So anyway, that's understanding horses and working with horses and hanging around them and understanding their herd and their relationship and their... I know. So, but he's going to come over here and kind of redo our relationship. I'm going to scratch him where he likes. He's going to get his little nuzzle up there. Get his little nose shaken and say, oh, I like that. And this is how we're bonding. We're spending time. When you're always pushing your horse and telling him, get out of your space and get away from me, and you better listen, and I told you to carry your head this way, and your head's too high, and don't you walk on me. You better respect my... Boy, I tell you, man, I feel so sorry for horses that got to live like that. Anyway, hope that helps on understanding a little bit of herd behavior, herd dynamics when you change horses. That's what happens, and I'm close to 15 minutes here. Now I can post 15 minutes, so it gives me a little bit more time to yak. Anyway, hope that helps.